Before all time, there was the noon, a sea of chaos, where all forms of what was to be lay hidden. Within the heart of the living noon stirred the spirit of the waters, the great snake, Apep. From the coils of Apep sprang Atum, the first god of creation, and the one became two. Apep embraced Atum in his coils, binding tightly to his second nature, trying to become one with himself again. But Atum transformed himself in the folds of Apep into the scarab god of becoming and broke free of his embrace. The serpent of chaos fought to return with Atum to the heart of the noon. But Atum overpowered Apep. Lying now alone in the waters, Atum thought of his children to be. In his heart he created their names and spoke them. Shu, the air. Tefnut, the moisture. And they were given form. Shu and Tefnut embraced their father, Atum, then left him to explore the limits of the noon. Alone once more in the dark waters of the noon. In his mind's eye, Atum watched the children lose strength as they ventured too far. Atum took the divine power of his eye and sent it to light their way home. could not be without the light of his eye. A new eye grew in its place, and in this new eye, Atum saw the return of his children. When the first eye returned, she was in fury at the one who had taken her place and tried to destroy it. But Atum placed her on his brow as his royal protector. In his heart, Atum created the first dry land, the mound, and with his children, Shu and Tefnut, brought it into being. From the mound, Atum spoke the name of his soul bird, Bennu, the phoenix. Bennu landed on the first dry land and laid his egg. Which was the lotus bud of the dawn of creation. From the heart of the lotus were born the many forms of the sun god, the divine light. Atum joined with the light of his creation, and Ra came into being. The light of Ra dispelled the darkness of the noon. On the mound, Shu and Tefnut gave rise to Geb, the earth, and Nut, the starry night sky. Nut swallowed Ra, who came between her and the embrace of her brother, Earth. Together, Geb and Nut conceived 5 children, but they could not be born till Shu, the air, raised his daughter, the night sky, from the earth so that the star children could break free. The star children were Osiris, god of the corn and of renewal, and his sisters Isis and Nephthys, and their jealous brother Set. Osiris was beloved of his sisters, but Set claimed Nephthys for his own. Osiris and Isis were lovers. Osiris lay as the earth, full of seeds. And Isis nourished the seeds. From the divine corn sprang the first seeds of creation which landed in the black earth. And the land of Egypt came into being. Isis drew down the waters of the heavenly Nile to give life to the land of Egypt. The waters rose, and Osiris called forth the first garden. Osiris and Isis were lord and queen of this divine garden, and their sister Nephthys came to be with them there. But Set was jealous of the creative powers of Osiris and of the love Nephthys bore him. He blasted the garden with a raging sandstorm, turning the good black earth into dirt. Set wanted also to destroy his brother Osiris, and they fought. When Osiris rested in his form of Lord of the Corn, Set cut him to pieces. And scattered the pieces to the four corners of Egypt. One piece of Osiris fell in the waters of the Nile and was swallowed by a fish. Were gathered up by Isis and Nephthys, who sprinkled the dismembered body of their brother with the water of life. Isis invoked the jackal-headed god Anubis, lord of embalming, to come and restore the form of Osiris. Anubis tightly bound the flesh of Osiris and created the first mummy. Which was covered by the first coffin. Isis sent her sister and Anubis away so that she could be alone with Osiris. She transformed herself into a kite and with her wings fanned life into Osiris, and through her magic restored to him for one night only the vitality of his manhood. Once more, and their son Horus was conceived. Set learned of the conception of this son and came to disrupt the union. But Isis escaped. She flew to the hidden waters of the Delta to keep her unborn child safe from the destructive powers of Set. And Horus was born. As he grew, Isis told Horus of the death of his father at the hand of his own brother. And Horus vowed to avenge Osiris. Horus faced Set. Two equally balanced forces, and they fought. Horus took the divine form of Falcon, and Set transformed himself through all the aspects of his nature to find a form which would conquer Horus. The eyes of Horus were the sun and the moon. Set destroyed the moon, and all was in darkness. Horus broke free. and hunted Set through the length of Egypt with his divine harpoon. Too evenly matched. So they called upon Thoth, lord of sacred knowledge and keeper of the scales of justice, to pronounce upon the winner. The hearts of Horus and Set spoke of all things, and the divine scales could not settle on a balance. Atum was called upon to be the final judge. Set could not resist a last attack on Horus. And the royal protector of Atum dispelled him, leaving Horus as the chosen one. Horus was crowned the first pharaoh of the land of Egypt. The help of his mother Isis, raised up Osiris and performed the rites of the dead. Horus opened the mouth of Osiris to let in the breath of life. Osiris was transfigured. And in his resurrected form became the Lord of the Underworld. Through his resurrection, Osiris brought divine truth and new life. Lighting the underworld as Ra lights the heavens. The light of Ra, the light of Osiris, is swallowed by the divine mother of night. At each dawn, she gives birth once more to the sun. The light and the life of Egypt.
O Ra, let your rays descend. Let your divine spirit fill the queen. Let her conceive. O Ra, let the queen breathe in the spirit of life. Let her see the twin souls of the Divine Pharaoh take form on the potter's wheel. Let her conceive. O Ra, let the queen see Isis on her journey to the Delta. Let her be present at the birth of Horus. Let her be full of her divine child. O Ra, let the gods of childbirth attend at the queen's chamber. Isis protect the queen in her confinement. Let the Pharaoh be born. Let the child go to his father to be blessed, so that he may receive his divine nature from the breath of Ra. Let the child be suckled, his human nature by his mother queen, his divine nature by Lady Isis. Let the baby Pharaoh keep his divine nature.
May the divine child grow at his mother's breast till he comes of age. And the priest comes to take the young pharaoh to the temple so that he may come to learn of the mysteries. Columns of the temple rise at the priest's command, like papyrus from the waters of the noon. The young pharaoh enters the temple. And he grows in learning of the mysteries of the creation and the passions of the gods.
Thank you.
the still of the inner temple, the priests of Horus and Thoth cleanse the young pharaoh with the pure waters of life, so that he may approach the shrine of the god.
O Ra, give a sign so that the Pharaoh may be confirmed.
He is the divine Horus, first of the pharaohs at the beginning of time.
Let Isis and Nephthys bring down the divine crown of Osiris. Let them bring down the double crown of north and south. May the land of Egypt be united and the people rejoice. May Osiris bless the land with corn.
Is Horus, who raises his father Osiris and gives him life, and gives life to the land of Egypt.
Let the Pharaoh go in procession through the land of Egypt. What the sun encircles is under his care. Let the sacred Nile take the boat of the Pharaoh through the land of Egypt.
He makes the Nile rise. He makes the land green.
O divine Horus, protect the Pharaoh from the dark powers of Set. Let your divine harpoon strike the enemy of the Pharaoh. Let the Pharaoh be in the first garden. Let him cut the first corn.
The body of Osiris is cut. The body of the Pharaoh is cut in the cornfield, where the Pharaoh dies. He goes to join the horizon. The soul bird of the Pharaoh flies from him, and the Pharaoh is dead.
Let Horus and Thoth cleanse the body of the Pharaoh. O Ra, let Set not take the body of the Pharaoh. Come to the Pharaoh, O Lord of Embalming. O Anubis, let the Pharaoh be preserved. Let Anubis take the intestines of the Pharaoh and place them in the jar of Gebsenweth. Let the stomach of the Pharaoh be in the jar of Duamutef. Let the lungs be in the jar of Hapi. Let the liver be with Imseti.
Osiris Pharaoh has his mouth opened, his senses are restored. And he is given breath. The Pharaoh lies in his coffin, and his soul bird departs to return to the Divine Father. And the soul of the Pharaoh joins Ra in his sunboat. In his boat of millions of years, Ra is swallowed by the night and descends to the rivers of the underworld. At the setting of the sun, Ra enters the caverns of the underworld, the god mind, the thinking heart of Ra, stands in front of him. The serpent who guards the desert of the underworld swallows the light of the dying sun. And the sunboat of Ra enters the cavern of the great snake Sordesheret. Ra takes on his nightly form of flesh, and the protecting serpent Mehen envelops the ram-headed Ra in his coils. The guardian serpent of the first gate of the underworld challenges the great god in his journey. The god mind says,
O flame face, I know thy name. I have power over thee.
Mind says,
O gate shining one, I know thy name. Open the underworld for Ra. Throw open the doors for the one of the horizon.
Those who lived in truth on earth are summoned to this gate.
O come to us, O light of the earth.
Ra speaks.
O you justified, the truth is yours that you may live.
O enemies of Ra, your evil deeds turn against you, and you are destined for the place of destruction.
All He sees all things. All thoughts are in the heart of Ra. The spirits of the justified dead join with the heart of Ra and he gathers strength.
O gate of sharp flames, I know thy name. Open thy doors for the one of the horizon.
Ra lightens the complete darkness and makes the hidden chamber bright.
The holy ones are in their shrines.
Open your shrine so that my rays may penetrate your darkness.
The doors close upon them when Ra has passed, and they wail forever. These are the gods in the lake of fire, which is refreshment to the just and destruction to the sinful.
Ra arrives at the barge of Earth.
The barge of Earth gives way before Ra. The barge of the underworld carries his forms.
Behold, he passes through the mysterious region. The earth quakes.
The eye of Ra lights up the mysterious region. And awakens the hidden forms of the god within.
Serpent Apep, the great god Atum cuts thy folds. The flame comes out against thee from the mysterious region.
O stinging one, open thy doors for the one of the horizon.
Hail Ra of the horizon.
These are the jackals round the lake of fire. The souls of the dead dare not approach because of the holiness within. These are the guardians of the flame which destroys the enemies of Ra.
Listen, you goddesses of the hours. Swallow what the serpent Hereret gives birth to, and give order to chaos.
Osiris is in his shrine. The light of Ra awakens the limbs of Osiris. And Horus comes forth to raise the spirit of his father.
O flame-eyed, open thy doors for the one of the horizon.
O serpent Manu, whose coils surround Ra in the darkness, you shall not overcome him. Your forms are swallowed by the justified dead. And your coils are straightened by the gods who dwell in this gate.
The living cobra is in the pool of fire. The souls of the gods dare not approach. Ra embraces the elements, the earth, the waters, the fire. And the air. This is Ra who comes to rest in Osiris. This is Osiris who comes to rest in Ra. The soul of the Pharaoh is alone in the underworld. He approaches the guardians of the gateway.
Kekhes net pehetwi ef.
Let the Pharaoh pass.
Sepedha.
Let the Pharaoh pass.
Where?
Let the Pharaoh pass. the Pharaoh confesses.
O swallower of shades, I have not stolen. O breaker of bones, I have not lied. O dangerous one, I have not killed men. O Nefertum, I have done no wrong. I have seen no evil. I am pure. I am pure. I am pure.
This is the hall of the double Maat, the hall of truth, where the goddess receives her own.
Pharaoh is true. Thoth records. The gods are satisfied. O Osiris, bless the justified Pharaoh. His heart is true. The divine light envelops the Pharaoh.
I am Osiris in the underworld. I am Ra in the heavens. I am Atum in the beginning, the first one, and the last one.
At the darkest point of the night, the great snake Apep returns. And embraces Atum in his coils.
These are the gods who straighten the coils of Apep, removing his power.
Set and Horus are as one. Behold his two faces in the mysteries. Thank you.
The great god of becoming emerges at the dawn. He is raised up by the noon. And the light of Ra fills the world.